welcome. And it sounds like you guys have a great art community going on here. And I'm really excited to get to participate for a little bit tonight. I think that you guys know that this is going to be a draw along. Because one of the fun things about dragons is there's always a story behind it, right? It's a fantasy creature. We can make up something about it. So in a moment, we're going to talk a little bit about some ideas about what a dragon could be doing. And we're going to make a dragon. So one of the things I advocate is in your art and in your life, find your dragon. Find something that you love to draw so that when you're having a day, when you need a little bit of art in your life, you don't have to think and wonder and like pull out your reference and five different things. Have something that you're like, I'm going to jump in. And when I stand up, I will have made something that needed me to be in this world. Something that I love to do. And now here it is. So what I want you to do is this is not going to have anything to do with our final piece other than it's going to kind of warm up our hand. So I want you to think, what is the most delicious kind of cloudy top of a cupcake with all sorts of ridiculous amounts of like frosting on top? And then just whatever those shapes are in your mind, I'm thinking that's a bunch of half circles. Let's do a bunch of half circles. This is the billowy top to a cupcake, and then half circle at the bottom. Line and half circle, and oh my gosh, we've got a giant.
So dragon heads to me tend to have this wonderful triangle coming out to the front
and then draw back and get a little bit wider in the back with some sort of horn, because I mean, you got to have some awesome sort of crest and horn if you're going to be a dragon. Otherwise, why bother? And then that back of that dragon head, I'm going to want to pay attention to the tilt, because somehow when we draw the eyes, they're going to be feel better and sit better if we match the tilt of the sort of the front of the eyes as the back of the head. It feels a little bit better constructed. And we're going to do two parallel lines to just kind of be that nice big sort of heavy brow that we expect on a dragon. And the dragon is looking down at these donuts going, "Hooly mooly donuts." So maybe actually this dragon surprised not by the flame, but by the rat. Maybe that's what made this whole moment happen. Here's my history. There we go. But we made it. We've got the donuts in the register. We've got our dragons. We ended up with wingless dragons today. That happens sometimes. That's okay. You don't need a dragon wing in the scene. Don't draw it. Yeah, there we go. We've got a whole counter scene. Everyone give yourselves a round of applause. We've got something that would never have existed without us showing up tonight and deciding that it would be fun to draw some dragons.